Pastor Jacob, and we have been doing so many Zoom meetings during this time of quarantine, and I have a special Zoom interview for you, a great guest to talk to us about stewardship, coming to us all the way from the downstairs of my house, Pastor Jen.
Hello, good to be with you this morning.
First of all, where does this idea of stewardship and giving to the church even come from?
Stewardship is based on the belief that everything we own comes to us as a gift from God. And with those gifts comes a responsibility to manage them with care. So this includes our environment, our time, and our finances.
I often hear the word tithe used. What does that word tithe mean?
Yeah, tithe means tenth in Hebrew, and that comes from the biblical practice of setting aside the first 10% of your income to give back to God. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 9, it says, "Honor the Lord with your substance and with the first fruits of all you produce." And first fruits is just a biblical way of saying that it's best to give to God first before you do anything else with your money.
Is pledging mandatory? Does someone have to do this?
Pledging is simply an invitation to be part of the investment in the health and life and future of Claremont UCC. We are here today, growing and thriving 130 years after our church's founding, because every year, faithful individuals like all of you have pledged to give part of their income to our ongoing ministries.
Why would someone pledge instead of just giving every week when they're at church?
That is a really important question. So putting money in the offering plate on Sunday mornings is very appreciated, and it does help support Claremont UCC. But by turning in a pledge, you're actually helping the church set our budget for the whole year so that we know about how much income we will have to support the ministries that we want to do this year. Pledges help us plan for building projects and renovations, innovative new outreach projects, and meaningful worship for our community. Pledging also allows you to financially plan your giving for the year ahead and make an intentional choice to include your church in your generosity.
Well, Pastor Jen, you and I always make a pledge. And as I think about how much should I pledge or someone else pledge?
That's a tricky question, because ultimately your pledge is between you and God. Scripture does call for 10% of our time, talent, and treasures, and that's what we talked about being a tithe. Some of us already tithe 10% or more, and others of us start with a percentage of our income with the goal of increasing our giving each year. And percentage calculations are included on the giving cards that everyone is receiving in the mail, and you can use that as an easy resource. But the most important thing to think about whenever you're pledging is that you're giving with a grateful heart for all of the blessings in our lives, and you're also giving with confidence that God's Spirit is at work at Claremont UCC.
It would be nice to know where my pledged money would go towards. What does our pledge go towards?
Claremont UCC relies on all of our members' generous giving to support every single one of our many diverse ministries. So beyond basic building and staffing needs, pledges support our weekly worship and musical guests, scholarships for our youth to attend special events like camps and mission trips, our annual fellowship events, our children's Sunday school curriculum, all of our guest speakers and lecturers, our online streaming and podcast platforms, the 20 different charitable organizations that we support financially. That's just to name a few things. And your pledge also ensures that our campus is able to continue providing reduced or waived rental fees for dozens of community groups and support groups who meet at the campus when we're open every single day of the year. And that includes our United Church of Christ conference offices, our Early Childhood Center, which is on site, and the Foothill AIDS Project nonprofit. Those are all housed in our building. Basically, every activity, event, and program of our church is totally funded by our congregation's giving. The more we all pledge to give, the more we can do together to shape our community and beyond.
What if I pledge more than I end up being able to give because maybe this quarantine goes on longer than we anticipated, or a change of jobs or unforeseen circumstances? Or on the flip side, what if my scratcher tickets finally pay off and I can give more than I thought I could? What do I do if I have to change my pledge?
Well, I will definitely be praying for that scratcher ticket scenario. But look, life doesn't always go as planned. We know that. And in the event that your circumstances change, you can simply contact our financial administrator, Jocelyn, to revise your pledge upward or downward. And just know that you are a valued member of Claremont United Church of Christ, no matter how much you give.
Can I submit a pledge after stewardship season is over?
Well, that's a trick question because technically stewardship season is year round, but we actually do need you to turn in your pledge card by May 17th in order for us to be able to set next year's budget.
We've probably heard this several times already, but just remind us, how can we turn in a pledge?
There are several ways that you can turn in a pledge. You can mail back the pledge card that you're going to receive in the mail. You can email our financial administrator at finance@claremontucc.org. You can go to our website and click Make a Pledge on the homepage, or you can set up a recurring donation, which is known as online giving.
If I did want to do online giving and set up a recurring donation, how would I do that?
Online giving is a great way to take the guesswork out of your giving. And you can set that up by going to our website. You click Make a Donation on our homepage, or you can call our financial administrator, Jocelyn, and she'll walk you through how to set it up step by step.
Will you send me reminders of how much I've given through the year, through statements or anything like that?
Yes, our financial administrator will send out mid-year giving statements in January and end-of-year giving statements in July.
That sounds great. Thank you for this interview, Jen, and educating us on the stewardship process. Look forward to a great stewardship season together.
Me too.